Today I'm going to talk about three tools that can help you stay organized. But first, I'm Jeff Bindner. This is the After the License channel. We help real estate agents build their business. Find us anywhere you get podcasts and anywhere you do social media type things. So staying organized is so important. I think personally and professionally, when we feel lost and we feel stressed, someone once told me when you feel stressed, it's most likely it's because you're disorganized. And I've tried to take that to heart. And when I do feel stressed or I feel like things are out of my control, if I take a step back and say, okay, let's make a list of this, right? Or let's get this organized. Let's get this jotted down. Let's put this project somewhere. I immediately feel more relaxed, more on top of things. I immediately feel like I have a better handle on the situation. So staying organized, especially as you start a business, especially as you get into real estate, is gonna be so important. So here are three tools, and I've talked about them in the past, but I wanted to put them in one video here for you. Three tools that I've used that I really like for not only personal organization, but professional organization as well. The first one is Trello. Trello is great. They have a free version. It's a very visual type organization system. So you can do your personal to-do lists in Trello. You can do business to-do lists in Trello. And you can also do more robust project planning via Trello. So I know people who manage all of their listings in Trello or all of their buyers in Trello, where they actually manage the listing process or the transaction to close process in Trello. Trello is super robust. If you go to Trello and look at some of the example boards that they have, and the best way to describe Trello is kind of like a Pinterest style visual project management tool. If you go and look at some of the example boards they have, people plan everything from vacations to weddings to I've done my personal to-do lists on there, my personal projects to work projects. So Trello is really great. They have a free version and then you can pay to upgrade to kind of get some of the more advanced features, but fantastic tool. If you've never checked it out, I would recommend it. The second tool that I would recommend for personal productivity, and this can be in combination with some of the other tools or on its own, is Todoist. Todoist is a fantastic to-do list application. Todoist is T-O-D-O-I-S-T, so Todoist, and it's a really robust to-do list application that syncs up with all of your devices. So you can access it online, you can access it on your tablet, you can access it on your phone. When you make one change one place, it changes everywhere. And I really like having a to-do list in that form because I can add things on my phone and then I can pull it up on my computer later. And what makes Todoist really robust is if you pay for the pro version, you can add and create your own labels, you can add and create your own filters, you can even do location-based reminders. And that's again the pro version, which costs a few bucks a month, but you can say anytime I go to the grocery store, remind me that I need to pick up avocados. And Todoist will do that for you. So a to-do list application like Todoist is really powerful and something you should check out if you haven't looked at it before. The third and final tool that I've just recently started to dive into that I'm a really big fan of is Airtable. Airtable. If you like spreadsheets and you like data and you like keeping yourself organized in that way, check out Airtable. Again, this is not a free tool. There is a cost to this, but Airtable is really robust in what you can actually build out. You can build out a list of things and turn it into a Trello style Kanban board, or you can view it in a timeline, you can view it in cards. So you can keep your database, your sphere of influence in Airtable. You can keep your to-do lists or your project in Airtable. And you can even keep your content calendar in Airtable. So Airtable is really robust. Again, it's kind of a combination of a database, but also a really robust Google spreadsheet, but has a million other different things that you can do with it. So go check out Airtable if you're like me and you've got a million different Google spreadsheets of different things. Airtable might be for you. Okay, guys, that was three different organization tools that you maybe haven't heard of that you can use to get yourself organized for the end of the year and the start of next year. I hope you enjoyed this. Drop a comment below if you have any questions, or even if you just enjoyed this video. The comments really help the algorithm, and I'll catch you on the next one.